It's been an incredible year for the Auki Network and Post-Mesh Protocol, and we've only just gotten started. At the beginning of 2025, Jensen Huang of NVIDIA set the tone for the year by explaining the work that we still have ahead of ourselves as a civilization. Even though generative AI has taken the world by storm, and we're now seeing agentic AIs capable of independently and creatively performing tasks, Jensen explained that the next and final frontier is physical AI, capable of understanding space, its surroundings, and physics, and how to manipulate the real world. This is important because as much as 70% of the world economy is still tied to physical locations and physical spaces. So without an AI capable of understanding space and physics, the majority of human productivity will be without AI assistance. This is why the Auki Network and Post-Mesh Protocol is so important, a fact that was not lost on Messari, who featured Auki prominently as a pivotal player in both their decentralized infrastructure and decentralized AI reports. Auki is poised to become one of the most important projects in AI, XR, and robotics. And today, we're excited and proud to share some of the amazing work that's been done in the last 12 months by us and our partners who are deploying this technology in the wild.
We have deployed a solution in different kind of industry scenarios and geography this year. Let me handpick some examples for you throughout Asia, Europe, and America. With MTL Hong Kong, we create an engaging AR experience in the Rethink conference. We let visitors to engage and interact with the digital object in a physical world. But this is only scratching the surface what Auki can do in the conference and hospitality sector. The Tayo Heritage Hotel used Makana to showcase the rich and colorful history. And conferences like ESG Exchange and Business Go Virtual used GoTo to help visitors to get the best out of the event. With our partner Toyota Material Handling, the forklift unit of Toyota, we demonstrate how spatial computing can improve workflow in smart warehouses, making it easier than ever to create and modify the digital twin that's necessary for autonomous and semi-autonomous work. With Mars Company, we have been exploring how augmented reality helps shoppers' journey in the store of the future. To truly understand how impactful augmented reality can be, even with your smartphone, let's look at the work we have done with our partner Zephyr.
We are here at AWE, the world's longest running and largest spatial computing expo. I'm here with Casper, the CEO of Zapbar, and together we are demoing something really extraordinary today. Casper, what did you build?
Well, I guess we've been really excited about everything that Auki have been doing with the Post-Mesh. And for us, it's been all about actually how can we bring assisted navigation to indoor spaces, and specifically in retail, because a lot of the work that we do as a business is how we can help the blind and low vision community actually access products and product information. And so we have this idea and this concept of an accessible QR code that exists on billions of packs around the world, well over 5 billion at the moment.
Wow.
Which is great, but how do we actually get that community to the shelf in a store environment? And the Post-Mesh and the work that Auki have been doing gives us a gateway to make that happen. And so we can layer a number of our bits of our technology within the Post-Mesh in terms of using our accessible QR code technology, but also our app clips to make that a very light app-less experience for consumers in order to get to that content quickly. And then Matacraft that sits on top of that, which is our content authoring platform that allows us to then create rich content in order to make these experiences not only available to the blind and low vision, but actually all consumers.
So today people are able to just scan one of these QR codes just using the normal camera.
That's it.
Like this. And when I open this, it opens what's called an app clip. I don't have to download an application. It just loads it straight into the RAM of my phone.
Yeah.
And I can navigate to wherever I want to go.
that's it. It's as easy as that. And I think it has to be that easy for it to be something that can get adopted by consumers, because they don't care about how the technology works. It's like, you know, no one cares about how the light goes on. It's about the ambience of the light that comes out of it. And it's the same here. What we're providing is a very, very simple way in order to think completely differently about an environment and how you might navigate it and how you might get greater productivity and greater efficiency out of it.
One of the things that we talk about a lot is the idea that we have to make the physical world accessible to AI. And what I find so compelling about the work we've done together with the navigation for the blind and the partially sighted is once you make the physical world accessible to AI, AI helps make the physical world more accessible to us.
Absolutely, and to everyone. I mean, I think that's the thing, is that it's the great leveler. And I think, you know, in the way that I guess Auki have been really interested in how they can bring robots into that equation, and we've been interested in how we can bring blind people into that, they're actually trying to solve the same problem for both that can benefit everyone in between. And that's super exciting.
So what's next? What's on the roadmap? What are we going to do?
Well, I think we've got to get into every single retailer in the world, for starters. And I think that's completely doable. But why stop at retail? I mean, this is something that is true of all locations, you know, all indoor locations. I mean, I think the other one that's so important is places like hospitals. You know, those are very, very hard spaces to navigate.
Absolutely.
All travel hubs, all these places. So I think our ambition should be, why not be at every single indoor location everywhere in the world?
Yeah, I'm excited to share that the pipe open now for retail locations looking at our solution is sitting at over $150 million ARR. So we're hoping that this solution will scale out very, very quickly. And it's been phenomenal seeing it live in an environment like this, surrounded by veterans that have dreamt of this being done. And now it's here. And Casper, congratulations on all of your success.
Appreciate it. Couldn't have done it without you.
The Auki ecosystem has grown to include visionary companies that are solving the problems of the AI century. We've been proud to support companies like Axial Robotics, Alpha AI, and Mentor Labs in their important and groundbreaking work, both with financial and technical support. Through the Auki grant program, we've funded and accelerated some of the most exciting nascent physical AI applications. Let's start by taking a look at our friend, Alpha AI.
Hong Kong is the most vertical city in the world. We got lots of tall building, and even not only building, infrastructure, buildings, looking people, vehicle, all packed in a set environment. And therefore, it's very challenging to do autonomous drone or even other autonomous devices. But if we can use all the drone data to build a high detail map, we can allow the drone to understand the physical environment, to navigate around the city, do the inspection, and also do the delivery using drone. And that is what we are building. In the near future, we have thousands, hundreds of drones flying around the city, and we need a positioning system that could allow all these drones to understand the environment, to work collaboratively, and also to navigate around the city. And we are building this physical AI infrastructure for the autonomous physical AI era. Traditionally, we have to send an inspector to see the building, to visit the site, to take photos of the building. But one thing is that's very time consuming. You will take several months to do the scaffolding around the building and then test the safety and test the condition of the buildings. But using drone, we can just simply take the photos from different angles on the building, and then we use the AI to find all the anomaly, and then we can map the photos with the building plan. So we can know exactly where the defect locates, how big it is, and also we can compare over time, maybe before, after the rainy seasons, or compare every year, so that we can even predict where is the next defect in future. So we take less than one day to finish a drone operation, to finish an AI inspection on buildings. We are building an AI inspection for a city. We are also moving from outdoor to indoor. So we have different drones that could navigate around the city, exterior wall, confined space, the area above the ceiling. We can use drone to go through all the area, and with the positioning system, with the high details map, that is how we can enable all the autonomous drone operation to be happening in futures.
Aksha Robotics is building personal tutors and companions for children deployed on the privacy-preserving Auki Network. Let's check in with them now to see how they're transforming the childhood education.
AI has a lot of potential to help our children. Childhood is way bigger than the screen. And as soon as our child starts to move, we want to encourage that. And we want AI to move with them and encourage them to do more. This is Rollbot, our first child companion robot. It encourages children to speak, to crawl, to walk, and move around the world. And it captures their photos and videos in the real time in the real world, right there and then. We believe one size does not fit all. As our children grow, so does their taste, their needs, and the devices and the interfaces they interact with. And we want an AI that grows with them and changes its personality with our children. Rollbot can hear, can speak, and can see. It is also specially aware of every nook and corner of your house. Our robots move from one body to another, which is age-appropriate for the kid, because a two-year-old has a different need than a 10-year-old. Working with Auki enables our robots to be specially aware and capable of interacting with the children in the real world. It's not just a chatbot, it's actually a playmate for your children in the real world.
We are incredibly excited to support Mentor Labs, the world's first open source operating system for smart glasses. With native Auki support at the OS level, these glasses are about to transform the face of personal computing.
Mentra builds the smart glasses operating system, apps, and hardware that you can wear today. And we're building it in a way that's fully open source and controlled by every individual user. And it allows multiple apps and AI agents to run at the same time on your smart glasses. It's the cross-compatibility layer for smart glasses that lets users download new apps onto their glasses and lets developers write one app that runs on any pair of smart glasses. We had a different problem. We realized that there was a major gap in hardware, and so we took our background in hardware development and started building Mentra Live, which is a pair of smart glasses with camera, microphone, and speakers. We realized that we needed spatial computing support. We needed the ability for Mentra Live to know exactly where it is in 3D space. And if we can do that, we unlock a huge number of new use cases. For example, we could unlock the ability to do indoor navigation, or we could allow retail workers to place notes in 3D space, like this.
I work at this grocery store, and as part of my job, I wear these Mentra Live smart glasses every day. Hey Cactus, we're out of Oatly. Please make a note of that.
I work in the warehouse of that same grocery store, and I just got a note on my phone that tells me that I need to stock up the Oatly. Let's go do it. Actually, it's my first day on the job, and I don't know where the Oatly is, but thankfully Cactus does, and it guides me in AR exactly to the shelf that I need to stock up, helping me do my job better.
In order to build the use case that you just saw, we need Mentra Live to be able to know where it is in 3D space. And that's exactly why we partnered with Auki. Auki's spatial computing stack allows us to send a single frame from the Mentra Live camera to Auki's visual positioning system. The visual positioning system then processes that frame and sends back a pose, which tells us exactly where Mentra Live is in 3D space, which is a huge unlock because now developers can build applications which take advantage of the exact position of the glasses in 3D space. Mentra is on a mission to build the de facto operating system for smart glasses, and to do so, we need spatial computing support. And Pose Mesh is how we make that happen.
It's been a remarkable year for Cactus, our own spatial AI for the retail industry. We've taught robots how to navigate and guide customers using the industry's fastest and smoothest setup process. We've allowed retailers to create heat maps about how their shelves are performing using real-world data instead of inaccurate assumptions from the planogram, allowing the retailers to make better and more profitable decisions about their stores. We've also showed how route optimization can save up to 40% of the walking time for in-store staff, and how that notes in shared augmented reality can improve in-store communication. The message is clear. Integrating spatial AI is an absolute game changer for retail operations. But we're only just getting started. This year, the next generation of Cactus will feature hands-free interaction with spatial AI through smart glasses.
Today, we've shown you how Auki is transforming how AI interacts with the physical world, both in the air through the intelligent use of drones, but also on the ground through interoperable robotic orchestration, and in our lives through all-day wearable smart glasses and accessible navigation for those with disabilities. We've accomplished a lot this year, but there's still a lot to be done. If you wish to contribute towards this vision of a fair, privacy-preserving, and intercognitive future, get in touch. Auki is ready to support you so that you can share your vision.